Hi, so I welcome back again. This is your boy, I'm Slink. Please try as much as possible, guys, as usual, to support your boy. Like this video, comment, share it on all the platform. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Adam's Link, and make sure you subscribe. And click the bell notification to get updates anytime, any day I upload. And meanwhile, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending on where you are watching this video from. Firstly, guys, let's talk about President Muhammad Buhari. And I know, let me just read what he said, I wonder why Nigerians accept me despite being poor. Speaking on Tuesday, July 13 in Abuja, they recalled the support he got during his presidential campaign, stating that he knew he needed to serve Nigeria to the best of his ability. The number of people that turned out to see me, some waiting for 10 hours in the sun, was more than anyone could buy or force. They just wanted to see who this Buhari was. People wonder why Nigerians accept me despite not being rich. I wonder too. I felt I just have to serve Nigerians and Nigerians to my best ability. The president further said Nigeria should congratulate themselves for being lucky to still remaining together despite challenges that could have torn everyone apart. So when you heard President Buhari saying this stuff, what is your first reaction? Yeah, what's your first reaction, guys? So should I read comments? I think I should do that. Someone said, I refuse to be triggered by this man in Jesus' name. Which kind mumu talk be this? God forbid, we did not accept you. You forced yourself on us. Who accepted you? Please forgive us for accepting us. This man, someone said, please forgive us for accepting you. This man supposed the act movie. This man, the Zuzu. We accept you because of your fake promises and lies, and a tone that will fire you. Be like, say, Bubu, don't change the law. Let me know when Nigeria gets a whole show on Netflix. Would they accept you, Papa? Well, guys, those comments that I read are not for me, so anybody should not come for me saying I'm calling Mr. President Mumu or all those kind of stuff. No, 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 I'm not the one calling him or Andes, please. Don't come for me. And meanwhile, can you leave a comment below? That is President talking. He said that up to now, he's still wondering why you guys accepted him despite being poor. You guys are poor. You guys are hungry. You guys are devastated. Insecurity is eating you up. Inflation, hiking price, no light. So many things. And yet, why did you guys accept President Muhammad Buhari for second term? If you guys are complaining, that's exactly what he's saying. If you guys are complaining so much, then why did you accepted me? So let me talk as Mr. President Muhammad Buhari now. Meanwhile, kindly leave a comment below, guys. And also, for those of you who are doubting, saying that Nigeria will never, ever, ever, ever be good again, I think you need to stop saying that. Well, this next person, a general overseer of a church, is Pastor Oyedepo, and hear what he says.
People who scorn your goals cannot add value to your life.
Yes, sir.
Caution! Caution! There are people you must delete from your list of contact. Delete them! Delete them! There are people you meet that will end your life. Delete them from your list. Amen. I love Jesus, and I'm telling you, by the Holy Ghost, don't be the enemy of your destiny. Get smart and walk in the truth. Get smart and walk in the truth. I love all ministers, but I'm not different to every minister. No, I can't be. Don't let us deceive ourselves. Nothing can work in Nigeria. I can't be your friend. I'm a repairer of the bridge. I can't hang around you.
Well, guys, I think it kind of addressed two things there. Firstly, he said he loved all ministers but can't be friends to all ministers. I think it was kind of like reacting to late Pastor T.B. Joshua. You know, people are complaining, saying that this general overseer, Evil Christian Association of Nigeria, never took the time to visit or to pay last respects to him at all when he died. So I think he kind of responded to that, and also he said that for those of you, it cannot be a friend to someone who said Nigeria will never work. Of course, guys, me on my own, I've equally like talk this particular statement a lot. I won't even come here to deny it. I've told my friends, see, whoever thought Nigeria go work, that person, you know, that person needs to rethink. I've said that numerous times with my friends. But at the same time, I honestly think that we should also try as much as possible to speak positivity. You know, positivity. Let us have this positive vibe. Let us still be hopeful that yes, a day will come that Nigeria will be great again. I saw this video of Davido, Tiwa Savage, and other friends visiting Obama's grave. And there's this news about Davido footing the bill for Obama's son and also his daughter as well. And according to this news, they said Davido made a promise to Obama that he will take care of his son. And that is what Davido is doing currently. In fact, Davido has secured a job for Obama's son. Already secured a job for Obama's son in his father's company. And also, he is currently footing the bills, the school fees, the transport fare, everything, feeding money concerning Obama's son as we speak. Well, that's a good one if that report is true. And meanwhile, guys, the guy died few days ago. May so continue to rest in peace. And Tiwa Savage is one of his close friends who was also there, visited the grave alongside Davido and also other crew members. So may so continue to rest in peace, guys. And don't forget, we love Sound Sultan as well, one of Nigeria's great artists. So may so continue to also rest in paradise. And guess what, guys? You guys know this woman, Laura T, one of President Muhammadu Buhari's aide. Well, you know, President Muhammadu Buhari has recently nominated her as a National Commissioner of the Independent National Electoral Commission. Well, guys, yesterday, the nomination was rejected by the Senate. Should I play the video? Yeah, I think so.
Will the Senate approve the nomination of Loretta Oneche as a commissioner representing Delta State in the Independent National Electoral Commission? Those in favor say aye. Those against say nay.
So guys, we already know this woman is upset with President Muhammadu Buhari. He's a great supporter of President Muhammadu Buhari. Maybe that is the reason why the Senate be like, come on, man, we cannot allow you to go into our INEC. The only thing that gives the Nigeria people some sense of hope that yes, they can choose whoever they want. And that the decision was taken on Tuesday, July 13, at the Senate resumed its sitting. It came after a report by the Senate Committee on INEC in which it was stated that a nomination breach federal character principle was considered. Well, they voted nay. So he wasn't nominated for that. With advice from actress Kate, she said, if money can solve everything, those who have it in excess would buy more time on heart, not fall ill and get cure for any disease illness. My Jesus is the only one I can depend on, not money, not fame. Well, it's good you guys should learn one or two words from this writing. And also, guys, let's talk about social media and how it has affected us, even not even kids, adults as well. Even up to today, I still try very, 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 very hard not to be carried away with this social media life. Because you go on Instagram, on Twitter, on Facebook, you see all different kind of things you are processing in your brain. As old as I am, just imagine what this youth at their 20s, how they will be like handling this social media of a thing. And meanwhile, check out what an American parent wrote, a philanthropist. He's well known. His name is Matt. He said, my kids will not have smartphones until they are old enough to get a job and buy it themselves. Little Larry, no advantage to children younger than that having phones. You are facilitating your child's psychological and emotional malfunction by giving them phone. Insanely stupid. If you really think your kids need a phone to get in touch with you, buy them one with no internet and limit or no text. Give a kid a phone with full internet access is straight up neglect. I mean, there's no excuse. What is wrong with you? My holders are hate. I see kids their age walking around with phones. Do their parents hate them? Why would you give an 8-year-old a phone with internet access? If you love them and care for their well-being, I really want to know what's your reason. Drive me crazy to see. Exactly, guys. In fact, you do not even need, let us talk about porn site. You do not even necessarily need to type any porn site before you can see any like a naked woman or any, you know, all those kind of things on the internet. When you just log into the internet, just take maybe a few hours before you know it, some sexy stuff will be coming your way. So guys, I really think, for me, I support him wholeheartedly. Get your child a phone, but limit the internet. No internet. No internet at all. And if you must get them devices just to like to play games, to enjoy themselves, entertainment, then get them devices with no internet. Get them devices with no internet at all. They can play games on it. Then get them an ordinary phone, touchlight phone. They can only reach you. Please, I know people will be like, okay, they have so much money. This man has money. Well, he's super rich. But yet, he doesn't see any reason why you and he doesn't see any reason why him will be buying his children a phone, a smartphone. Why? Me also, I've on numerous occasions advised my friend who are married, who have kids. Men, you do not have to buy your kids phone. Smartphones, give them touchlights. If there's any emergency, they can reach out to you with that touchlight phone. It not necessarily must be a smartphone where they can just access the internet. Before you know it, it might not be them accessing anything, but nowadays when you go into the internet, you see a lot of information. Honestly, man, up to today I keep thanking God that I myself, despite I'm dealing with this internet drama, I still have a way of trying as much as possible to balance it. And yet I'm trying. It's not easy. You think you are not carried away, but honestly, you should really check your life and stay away from phone for like, let me say, 3 days. I tell you, you will fall sick. Me myself, I can't stay away from my phone for 2 hours, even an hour. I've seen it, but I try as much as possible. Father, guys, here is a post a man made when he saw a dad and his daughter out on a date. This man decided to take his daughter out on a date, and they were having critical discussion. Honestly, I kind of like encourage this kind of stuff. Me, myself, if God ever give me the opportunity to have children, honestly, if it's a girl, I am looking forward on being their first best friend. Their first boyfriend. Boyfriend not in the kind of way you think of. Boyfriend in a way that I'll be the first person to take her out on a date. Be the first person to speak to her critical discussion. And be the first person to share so that she could share secrets with her. I know some of you say, Adam Slink say, boyfriend, please don't allow your corrupt mind to think different things. And that if it's a boy, I will be their first best friend. Their first boyfriend as well, so that we can both have critical discussion. I really think we are neglecting so much things as parents. Parents are neglecting so much things. Me, myself, I never had the opportunity to go out on a date with my own dad or with my own mom. Never, never. I can't remember. The only thing I remember is beating, fear. Fear is what I remember. And this man wrote, he said, at this sit out, and this father took his teenage daughter out on a date. I can hear what they are discussing from my seat. She's telling her every single thing about her life. Lately, the boys toasting her, challenges in school, everything. Her father listened to her without judging and then proceeded to advise her, yelling her his own experience when it was young. She even told him about a boy in school that kissed her. He didn't judge her at all. My God, I almost shed tears here. I'm not sure this man grew up in Nigeria, because for most Nigerian fathers, everything they know about fatherhood is, my friend, go and read your books and come and check these clothes, whether it will size you. That's all they know, nothing else. Sometimes your children just want to talk to you. It's not always about providing. Descend yourself from this high horse. Don't be a ruler on your children. Be their friend. Most children don't have anyone to listen to them, so they end up sharing their problem with the wrong people who give them bad advice, which can ruin their life forever. Nigerian father, learn from this man. Take your children out individually without your wife, without other children. Let them know that they can talk to you about anything. That's what fatherhood means. Exactly, guys. What they know. Yeah, come over there. I will slap. All those ruling over your children. You give birth to children, you are ruling them as a president, as a tyrant. Come on, man. Be a friend to them. Interact with them. Take them out individually. I remember the first day I stole my father's money. Let me tell you a story. This is a personal story. The first day I stole my father's money, you know what my father did to me? My father called other siblings, brought them out and brought me out. Disgraced me. See, he stole my money. I caught him. Disgraced me that day. Honestly, up to today, the trauma, the things I felt, I still recall and I just laugh. They don't know better, but I think the new fathers, the new parents, if you are intended parents, please learn. Let your child be your best, be your child's best friend. And to end this video, I just have some few things to say. And meanwhile, Senate approved 20 years jail term for candidate snatching ballot material. Well, do you agree 20 years is that enough? Those candidates, political candidates who are using, or anybody snatching ballot materials, if caught, will be sentenced to 20 years in prison. Well, I think 20 years is too small, because snatching of ballot balls actually indirectly or directly affect our lives, our future. So I think they should get like a life sentence. FT sentence is, see, they can say 30 years without parole, like 30 years without bail, no option of bail. Then life imprisonment, 30 years minimum, then life imprisonment as maximum. That is what I expected them to do. And also, they also said they are also proposing 18 years as the minimum age for JAMB candidates. We say JAMB candidates, we have seen candidates writing JAMB at the age of 15, 16. They are already in school at the age of 16. They are graduating at the age of 20, 21. We have seen it, guys. We have seen it. I see people, they be like, oh, I've graduated. How old are you? 20. I be like, How? That days, you can even see 13 years old writing JAMB. 13 years old writing JAMB. Well, the Senate are proposing 18 years as the minimum age. Well, do you agree with that? And check out these statistics. I know it's really not good, but according to statistics, over 2,300 people kidnapped in Nigeria and 10 billion demanded in the last 6 months. For the past 6 months, over 2,300 people have been kidnapped in Nigeria and more than 10 billion naira has been demanded for their release in the last 6 months in Nigeria. So we are praying, even those ones that we do not know about, or those ones that we do not know about, or those people that are busy, because nowadays, kidnappers, let me tell you that secret. They are no longer asking for more money, those ones in the South South. You know what they do? They just kidnap you guys, and immediately they start calling, 500,000, 1 million, they release, they go to. It's not a really, really lucrative business for people. And it's quite disheartening. And to end this video, federal government budgeted 4.8 billion to monitor WhatsApp satellite phones. 4.8 billion to monitor our WhatsApp. Our WhatsApp. Well, I thank you very much for watching this boy here. I'm saying, have a wonderful day and stay blessed. And watch out for my next video. Don't go anywhere. Peace.